Hey, we're going to get rolling here today and just kind of want to give you a quick hitter with this USDA report. But I have to tell you, here over the noon hour at our office, we had tornado sirens going off. And then they said, you need to implement your tornado plan. And in our office, we kind of looked at each other and we don't have a tornado plan. So we sat there and hope things passed over, and they did. But hey, let's get to this report here quick. We oftentimes talk about lean heading into this report, and what we thought we saw is that the trade was leaning more bullish to corn, more bearish to soybeans. And when you look at that lean, that's where you tend to see more of a market reaction depending on what the numbers are. But I just want to give you some corn highlights here. I mean, to the surprise of the trade, the yield came down from 172.5 in September down to 171.9 in October. I mean, we don't want to make that big of a deal of it. I mean, we thought unchanged, maybe slightly lower. Ending carryout levels came down then as well too, from 1.2 down to 1.172. That was really in line with expectations. The USDA did drop exports 125 million bushels due to the slow pace. If you want to be bearish on corn longer term, you're going to look for that export number to continue to drop. World carryout then followed the U.S. figures. All in all, this report was a little bit more neutral, okay? But on the other hand, the lean heading into it, what was positive, that's where we saw some initial pressure. And then beans carried us back to unchanged by the end of the day. Get to the bean number, and this is where the support came from. You know, everyone was thinking this yield would be left unchanged. It dropped down to 49.8 bushels an acre. I'd have to say over the last week or so, what we've been hearing from producers is bean yields, you know, maybe a little bit disappointing. The corn yield is held together. And so as we move forward in here right now, this corn crop stabilized. Maybe this bean yield is low enough. What ended up happening then is the USDA kept ending carryout at 200 million bushels, where everyone was expecting them to be up around 245 because of the higher carry-in levels. To keep carryout at 200 million bushels, the USDA had to lower exports down to 2.045 billion bushels, down about 40 million. We're not going to disagree with that, with the potential for a big Brazil crop. World ending carryout levels increased though, even with the US unchanged. And to me, the biggest surprise of the report was the USDA increasing Brazil production by 3 million metric ton with only 15% of the crop planted down there. So, you know, this bean report really leans more bullish in here right now. And the trade was leaning short heading into this. That's where we had the higher trade. As we take a quick glance at the November bean chart, you got the 40 and 50 day moving averages around the 14, 17, 14, 18 levels. Today's high was 14.14. If we can get a push above there, you know, 14.50 probably would be a fairly easy target from the techs. When we get to the wheat market in here right now, I mean, you know, you had the ending carryout on wheat dropping from 610 down to 576. The production was known from the end of September report. And then the USDA dropped the carryout down to 775 million bushels, down 50 million. I mean, I'm a little surprised that they dropped exports as much as they did. But you know what? Hey, I'm not going to argue too much with them on the wheat side of it. World ending carryout levels declined modestly. We think the biggest thing with wheat, though, is when you look at the different classes of wheat. Right now, you got soft red winter wheat ending carryout at 91 million bushels. That was down a whopping 34 million from that September report, but real similar to last year. Hard red spring ending carryout levels were 140 million last year. Even with a big crop, they're forecasted to go down to around 130 million in here. So it's showing you a decent demand base. The most bullish, though, is hard red winter wheat carryout in the upper right-hand corner, as that dropped from 360 million bushels down to 253 this year. And with the dry weather in the southern plains right now, I mean, you've got to give the edge to KC wheat if that is a market that's going to head higher. All in all, though, this report on wheat was mostly neutral. You could even just say maybe slightly negative in here, as the U.S. carryout did not drop as much as the bulls were expecting. As we want to wrap up in here today right now, I mean, bottom line is U.S. numbers on beans were bullish, but we need to keep in mind that the world was a little more bearish on the whole thing. We think it's, again, the lean on it, and now with harvest pushing past at 50%, there should be pretty good support on this. The corn report was mostly neutral. I think the thing looking ahead in here right now is that we believe harvested acres need to drop as more corn was chopped for silage, especially through the drought areas of the country. And then you're going to have the bears in the market are going to say, look, at these exports are still too high. On wheat, again, it's a non-factor. It's all about Russia-Ukraine. As we look to the end of the week, we think this market's going to find some support as the tensions, you know, between Russia and Ukraine just are not easing up. Look towards our report tonight. Any suggestions for our webinar, let us know. Have a great evening.